You know the maddest thing as well, yeah? So the link to that video, Feminine Boys, hey, watch it if you want. Don't matter if you don't, innit, yeah? Believe you me, Nadia would vouch for me as well, but Nadia's gone to sleep now, innit, yeah? I threw away my Scooby-Doos. I had them, you know, from when I was 13. They were just underneath my bed, yeah? I had them from when I was like 13 years old, and I only threw them away a couple of weeks ago, hand on heart, yeah? So I had the Scooby-Doos for like 14 years, yeah? Now, I made a video talking about feminine boys, yeah? And, like, imagine me and my cousin are two boys, and we're sitting, it was either in that video or another video, but anyway, I mentioned it in one of my videos. Me and my cousin are boys, and this is how mothers feminize their sons, yeah? How can two mothers, yeah, be promoting their sons? So me and my boy cousin, who's the same age as me, he's not my brother, we were at his house, him and I, my mother and his mother were all sitting in the living room and were basically making Scooby-Doos. We're basically knitting. That's like feminizing your boy children. We're sitting. To make a Scooby-Doo is like to fucking knit. So you basically got two boys and their mums knitting in the sitting room. That's like feminizing that stuff. This is the most important reason why men need to be in their children's, within their sons' lives. Yeah. Like me personally, I don't even think it's really the dads per se. 100% of the time, 100% of the time, that's going to stop their sons from becoming gang members and stuff like that and going down the wrong path, right? But let me just break this down quickly, innit, yeah? For me, right, I don't think it's necessarily the fathers and that keep their children, keep their sons on the right path, right? I think it's just, you need to put your children, your sons in the right environment, yeah? Whether Mayweather or... what's that guy's name? Future. Yeah, Future's got like, what, 6, 10 baby mums or whatever in it, yeah? He ain't going to be in all of their lives like that, yeah? He ain't going to be the at-home dad like that, yeah? So pretty much, his children, his sons, yeah, are going to grow up with a stepfather or whatever in it, yeah? Whether he's in the life or not, but you can't be in six places at once, innit, yeah? But I guarantee you this, Future's sons will not be gang members, because more than likely they'll be living in the suburb somewhere where there's no gang members, and they'll probably be going to private school where there's no gang members, yeah? But the most important aspect of a man being in his son's life is to stop him from being feminine, yeah? Teaching him how to be a fucking man, yeah? There's no way, right? If my dad was around, I would be sitting in a room with him making Scooby-Doos. What kind of fucking bullshit is that? Grown man sitting with his son doing this, weaving. No. And a lot of, if you don't believe me right now, yeah, maybe Justin, you can back me on this, you can vouch, because Justin, you're older than me, yeah? But it don't even matter about age anyway, yeah? You might realize this now, yeah? The next time you observe a child, yeah, a boy child, right, who's like 5 or 6 years old or whatever, and maybe even 4, yeah, and he comes from a single parent household, he solely lives with his mom. He don't have a stepfather, he don't have a father figure. He solely lives with his mom, yeah? Watch and observe his mannerisms and his body language. Does he act girly? Does he act feminine? Now, not all boys. There could be some boys who come from a single parent household, have no stepfather, yeah? They live with their mum their whole life, whatever, innit? And they're masculine as fuck. But it's probably because they were out on the road with the man them anyway, yeah? But more than likely, if a boy child, right, grows up with his mother, he has no dad in his life, or his dad doesn't play a significant role in his life, yeah? He will grow up to be very, very feminine, yeah? Shit like crying over foolishness. I've been in surroundings, right, and been around little kids and that, and just watched them. Come here, I like to observe body language and that. And I was at a little kid's house one time, and it was his birthday, and another child took this boy child's toy off of him, and he cried. What the fuck are you crying for? Take the fucking toy back. It's your toy, and you're in your own house. What are you crying for? Just slap the shit out of him, man, about crying because another child has taken your toy. No, why don't take your fucking toy back, man? Stop being a bitch. Shit like that. If that boy had his dad in his life, he would not be acting like that. Would not be acting like that. So for me, the most important role of the fathers is to make sure that the sons do not grow up to be feminine, right? Because no matter how masculine your dad is or how much of a good role model your dad is, right? If your peers are bad, then, you know, there's a chance your child could go down the wrong avenue, right? But if you put your child, like, there's no way, right? A child can grow up in the suburbs and go to private school and become a gang member, right? Unless he's really going out of his way to go down to downtown and that, yeah? And out of 100 boy children who grow up in the suburbs and go to private school and have peers who are positive and they're not like that, yeah, maybe one of them is going to be that jackass that still goes down downtown and wants to bang out with a mandem or whatever in it, start rolling with a mandem in it, yeah? So for me, the father's most important role is just teaching their son to be men, yeah? Teaching their sons to not have this bitch mentality that, oh, because we're black, we're oppressed. Or because we're from this black background, we're oppressed. Oh, there's a glass ceiling for me. I can't get so far in life, whatever. Anything. That's the most important role of a father that I believe, yeah? I believe, because as I said, future is not going to be in all of his... I don't know how many sons he's got or whatever in here, but I can't imagine him being in all of his children's lives like that, yeah? But I'm telling you, they're not going to grow up to be drug dealers or whatever like that, because they're going to live in a rich area, they're going to go to a decent school, their peers are going to be good, positive people, whatever in here. They ain't going to get involved in that foolishness. They might do drugs like sniff cocaine and stuff like that, but they ain't going to be out peddling, and they don't need to. They don't need to. So for me, the most important role of a father is to just teach his son how to be a fucking man, yeah? And not grow up to be like these bitches that are walking around nowadays. Man, them crying and shit. What are you fucking crying for? You're a grown ass man. Man, like a proper, listen, there's no way, right? If your father is a man's man, yeah, if your father is a man's man, like a proper man's man, you know what a man's man is, like a proper man's man, yeah? If your dad is a man's man, you cannot come home with a fucking teddy bear in your blazer breast pocket. I'm sorry, no. You gotta take that and make you fucking eat that Ross Clark teddy bear. Yeah, if your dad's a proper man's man. The most manliest man that I've ever met before, right? And as I said, it's not about being 6'3", or handsome with a gold tooth in your mouth and tattoos all down your arm and on your neck and that, and scars here and that. No. The most masculine man, the manliest man that I've come across before, like a real man's man, yeah, a man that don't smile, a man that don't laugh, a man that don't joke, no goofy, foolish behavior in it, yeah? A straight up fucking man. The manliest man that I've come across was when I was at Taekwondo. One of the senior instructors was called Dennis. And like, he was like a fourth dan black belt. And back then I was like a red belt, which is a one before black. Probably when I was a black belt as well, he was around, but he went to America. Now, he was a proper man's man. Like, everyone, we was terrified of this guy. Yeah. He was a big man, isn't he? Like, older than my parents. Really. So he was a big man, isn't he? So I was all like 12, 13, 14 years old. And yeah, when I was 15 or 14 years old, he went away for a little bit and he came back. And during Taekwondo, we're not allowed to wear any jewelry. Yeah, you can't wear any hats. You can't wear any, yeah, no jewelry, nothing like that. Take your watches off, your chains off, because remember, we're fighting, stuff might get caught and that. Xavier, you will know, you can't wear any jewelry whilst you're practicing Kung Fu. It's just not practical. Isn't it? So at the end of the class, our stuff, we leave all of our like coats and jackets and trainers near a bench on the side, innit? Just keep it out of the way. So I was putting on my stuff, putting on my trainers, putting on my jacket. Back then I used to wear an earring, yeah, in my left ear, yeah? I'm there. I used to put my earring in my trainer just to keep it safe, innit? Because if it's on the side of the bed, someone can knock it over. So I used to put my earring in my trainer to keep it safe. I took my earring out of my trainer. I'm all, yeah, doing this. My guy, yeah, has looked at me and said, and he raised his chin as well. He said, what type of a man wears an earring? And from that day, from that fucking day, mother's life, I stopped wearing an earring. 12 years ago, when I was 15 years old, the man asked me, what type of a man wears an earring? And from that day, I never wore an earring before. Remember back in the day, yeah? So like when I was 15, what? 2008, yeah? Yeah, 2008, yeah, when I was 15, yeah? Man, you know them big, massive diamond, fake diamond, obviously. You know them stupid cubics of corner, stupid earrings that you buy from Argos that cost £20 for some fat diamond. I had one of them diamond earrings, innit, yeah? One of them fake diamond earrings, yeah? But he seen me put this thing in it, he said, what type of a man wears an earring? And 12 years ago, he said that to me, and from that day, I stopped wearing an earring, because I realised, you know what? Yeah, this is not manly, you know? Even a fucking boy from Jamaica, right? When I was in year 5 in school, when I was 10 years old, this boy from Jamaica came over to my class, yeah? His name's Sahesna, yeah? He said to me in school, right? You're a girl. Yeah, he had a proper Jamaican accent back then, innit, yeah? You're a girl. Why are you wearing an earring? Like, a proper Jamaican, you innit, yeah? You're a girl. Why are you wearing an earring? I thought, you know what? But I didn't really listen to him or whatever, innit? But I thought, you know, this guy's a bit rap, but I still continue to wear the earring, innit? You think if I have a son, he's fucking having an earring? No. I'm not getting my son's ear pierced, yeah? All is a man them got both their ears pierced as well. Nah, fuck that bullshit. Nah. I don't care if it's a manly earring. I don't care if it's like a Mr. T pirate looking earring. No. Yeah, you know that with the hoop thing. Nah. My son ain't wearing no fucking earring. When I have a son, he ain't having no plaits in his hair. He's having short hair like his papa. Yeah, that's it. None of this long plaits and pretty hair. I used to have long hair back in the day. I used to have cornrows, you know. I used to have hair. My hair was so long back in the day, yeah. No word of a lie. Like, I could tie it back in a bun. Like, I would. My hair was too big, too long to be in an afro, yeah. So, like, if I took my hair out, yeah, it would just be long. I could actually tie my hair back. Man. I'll never. No, my son's not having no long ass hair like no gal. When he's older, when he's a big man, then if you want to do plaits or dress, he can do that on his own back. That's cool. Yeah? But no, not when he's young. No. I'm not letting my son even hang around. Like, if I have a son, right? Say, like, he's 5, 6 years old. If he has a girl cousin, he's going to her house and staying with her. Having sleepovers with his girl cousin. No, I'm not associating with girls like that. I want no girls rubbing off on my son or nothing like that. No. Maybe, do you know what? Maybe he could play with one girl cousin, but he's not like hanging around with like 3 or 4 girl cousins. No. You can pick up them feminine body language and feminine energy. No, it's not happening. Not fucking happening. If I ever had a gal, If I ever had a girl, I got a girl pregnant and she had a son, man. And we split up, obviously. I'm doing my best to get custody of that son because I know if I'm not around him on a daily basis, he's going to pick up this feminine body, weak body language, his feminine traits, yeah, because we are what we hang around with, yeah? Irrespective of genders, yeah? A boy that hangs around with his mum, he's going to pick up feminine traits, crying, emotional. Yeah, sitting with his legs cross-legged and, you know, just weak body language. I've seen it. I know little boys like that. They're just taking pictures with their tongue sticking out there, man. What the fuck you doing, fam? You're going to be, I ain't going to do it. I ain't no fucking bitch, but you're taking pictures with your tongue sticking out of your mouth. With your mum. So your mum's posing with her tongue sticking out of her mouth. Just picture it. Yeah, I ain't going to do it. Your mum's posing with her tongue sticking out of her mouth. And you're doing it as well. A bunch of little girls. You're turning that boy into a little girl. And then the worst thing is, right? You know that people, they can't take the truth, yeah? I've seen a picture where, as I said before, a girl has taken a picture of her son and they got their tongue sticking out or whatever, and it just looks feminine as fuck. I can see the fucking estrogen tattoo on both of their foreheads, yeah. If I was to pull the mum up and say, you know, you're making your son into a little girl like that, you know. Oh, Jay, you're just being too harsh and shit like that. But when that boy grows up, man, and women don't want to, aren't attracted to him because he don't present that masculine energy, yeah? And he complains to his mum, oh, mum, girls aren't attracted to me or whatever, innit, yeah? She's not going to know why. Well, I'm fucking telling you, I try to tell you why, but you don't want to listen. Yeah, you don't want to listen, yeah? That's why a lot of men them struggle with girls, because they didn't have a man around, yeah, to teach them how to be a man. So when they grow up and it comes to time to attracting women, yeah, they don't have them masculine traits like that. They're in touch with their feminine side too much. Yeah. A girl don't want to be with a fucking girl. A girl wants to be with a fucking man.